every day when I wake up. I can see His mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, His plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace. Good morning to each and every one of you. This is Pastor Daryl Fair, and I want to welcome you to Fresh Start. It's our morning devotion. We meet every single morning around this time, 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And it's our time to fellowship for just a little bit in the chat area, focus our thoughts, and build our faith as we apply God's word to our lives. It's always a blessing to begin a brand new day. And we know that because Lamentations chapter number 3, verse 23 says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is His faithfulness to you and I. And so we know that every day that we wake up, every day that we know that we are alive, not only did God bless us with a brand new day, He's given us a fresh start, full of grace and full of His mercy. With that being said, of course, we've been dealing with bugs, and we've been dealing with the concept of freedom this week. Of course, here in America, we have observed the 4th of July, commonly referred to as Independence Day. We've been looking at freedom and liberty from a biblical perspective. And this is where we were on yesterday, where we were dealing with the subject of in Galatians chapter number 5, verse number 13. It says, brethren, you have been called into liberty, but don't use this liberty as an occasion to the flesh. In other words, don't allow what you are free to do cause you to be so free that you even engage in your fleshly desires. I gave the example of yesterday, the legal age for drinking alcoholic beverages. And of course, in this country, you are free to do that if you meet the age and if you have enough money to purchase the alcoholic beverages. However, there are people who have consumed those kinds of beverages and they are now bound by them because they have an addiction. And so that's one classic example of having the freedom to do something, but now being bound by that same freedom. And Paul uses Galatians 5 as a warning as such to those of us who live in the freedom of God and the freedom that God provides to us through Jesus Christ. And so one of the things that I'm doing is looking at it from a biblical perspective. Look at this passage of scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter number 8 and in verse number 9. Paul says, but take heed or pay attention, lest by any means this liberty of yours become a stumbling block to them that are weak. Consider that. Paul says, pay attention so that you don't allow your liberty, your freedom, to become a stumbling block to other people. And the concept really is simple. God brings us into, remember in Galatians 5, He says we were called into this liberty. This call into liberty in Christ Jesus gives us the freedom to do things as God leads us to be able to do them according to the scripture. But there are times when people have not engaged in the same kind of freedom that you and I have observed or have believed enough to apply that level of truth into freedom in our own lives. Paul talks one time, and it may be in the same context, about being able or free enough to eat certain kinds of meat. Remember in the Jewish context, there's certain meats they were not supposed to eat, certain things they were not supposed to eat of, but in grace, they had the freedom to consume those things. But there were some people who had been trained a certain way for so long, it was difficult for them to make the switch from the law into grace. And so Paul says, just because you are free enough to do this, please consider your brothers and sisters. And so one of the things that he really mentions is that God's idea of freedom includes concern for other people. There are some people who are so free that they don't really care about other people. And, you know, I'm walking in my freedom. I don't care who agrees with it, who doesn't agree with it. I'm walking in my freedom. Christ has made me free. I'm not going back into bondage. And all that sounds good until we remember that we are in a spiritual family. And it is possible to be free in an area that my brother and sister may not be free in that same area. And I can become, through my freedom, I can become a stumbling block to someone else. And so God's idea of freedom includes concern for other people. The concept of I'm free and I don't care what anybody feels or thinks about it is not 100% biblical. It is, if I can say it this way, it's almost selfish to the degree that I'm free and I don't care who thinks or what you think about it. I'm walking in my freedom. And again, as a preacher, that sounds good as a preacher. That's some good preaching points there. But when I understand that I am in a spiritual family, God has given me brothers and sisters that may not be in the same level of freedom that I'm in. And so I need to be concerned about others. And so I can't be so free that I misuse and abuse and hinder and block and cause others to stumble. Just because I'm free in a particular area doesn't mean that everyone else has grown or matured to that level of freedom, and I need to be aware of other sensibilities and others' growth. And so with that being said, as we step into a brand new day and further into this weekend, let's be mindful with our freedom of others, and let's trust God to increase our level of discernment so that we can be a blessing to others. God willing, I'll see you in the morning. God bless.
The gospel, this is the good news. Tell everybody. There's a God that loves you. Oh, how he loves you. There's a God that loves you.